Out beyond the eight planets that you already know, there are many more solar systems to explore, and we should go. Different stars that have their own planets and their own solar systems. Would you like to go with me and see if we can meet some? The closest star to your sun is Proxima Centauri. I'm an exoplanet that orbits it, named Proxima Centauri b. In a triple star system with stars Alpha Centauri a and b, I'm in the habitable zone, which means there could be life on me.
I'm 51 Metis ID, also known as Dumidium. I was the first exoplanet found orbiting a star much like your sun. I'm about half the mass of Jupiter, but with a larger diameter. My orbit takes only about 4 days because I'm very close to my star.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them. Kepler 16b, also known unofficially as Tatooine. Like in Star Wars, a planet that orbits not one but two stars. My orbit is circumbinary. That means I travel around both stars instead of only one. And you would see two sunsets on me when the day is done.
My name is Methuselah, one of the oldest planets known yet. I'm about 12.7 billion years old, almost three times older than your planet. I have a circumbinary orbit around two burnt-out stars, a very old white dwarf star and a neutron star, pulsar.
I'm the exoplanet J1407b, also known as Super Saturn, but Saturn's got nothing on me. Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
An exotic exoplanet, I'm HatP7b. I have very different weather from yours, especially when it rains on me. Instead of raindrops, you would see showers of sapphires and rubies. I have clouds of corundum that could make those jewel scientists believe.
I'm exoplanet Wasp 12b, and I'm a very strange sight to see. I'm all stretched out like a football because my star is pulling on me. That's because I'm so close to my star, it takes just over 1 day to orbit. I'm one of the darkest exoplanets because I eat up light. I absorb it.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them. I'm TOI-700D, and I'm an exciting discovery. I'm in the habitable zone of my star, which means there could be life on me. I'm a little bit bigger than the Earth, and we could be very similar, they say. I could have oceans and land and friends for you to meet someday.
When my star expanded to a red giant, it almost vaporized me. A subdwarf star now, I'm much closer to my star than other planets would dare be. I'm super fast, a less than 6 hour orbit. I'm so close that it's fun. hotter than hot. I'm Kepler-70b, and I'm probably hotter than your sun.
My name is Trappist the Star. I have 7 planets of my own. All unique and special, including 3 in the habitable zone. Their current names are Trappist B, C, D, E, F, G, H.
Hey.
Together we have one of the most exciting solar systems discovered to this day.
Out beyond the 8 planets that you already know, there are many more solar systems to explore, and we should go. Different stars that have their own planets and their own solar systems. Would you like to go with me and see if we can meet some?
I'm TOI1338, and I was a surprising discovery. I was found by a teenage intern named Wolf Suki Earth that just started work at NASA recently. I orbit both stars in my solar system. They are binary. So I experience stellar eclipses very regularly.
If you are a Star Trek fan, then you will definitely be a fan of me. Unofficially known as Vulcan, I was discovered where Star Trek predicted Vulcan to be. I orbit an orange star in a triple star system named 40 Eridani A. Only about 16 light years from Earth, I'm 40 Eridani AB. Come visit me someday. Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
My name is COROT7B, and I'm bad to the bone. I've been mistaken for the underworld, so you definitely wouldn't want to call me home. I'm close to my star when orbit only takes 20 hours. My surface is covered in volcanoes and lava, not flowers. The sky literally falls on me as I rain down rapture steam. A real nightmare it would be if you lived on me.
PSRJ1719-1438B. I have a really long name, but that's not all that's special about me. I orbit an actual millisecond pulsar, a super fast spinning neutron star. And I'm so incredibly dense, I'm probably made of crystalline carbon, the giant diamond. How bizarre.
I'm darker than night. I absorb the light. I'm TRES2B. I'm a gas giant planet a little bigger than Jupiter, but I'm definitely not jolly. Darker than coal with an eerie red glow, I can be a little bit scary. Consumed by heat and darkness, you'll never know the secrets that I carry.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
A glamorous exoplanet! I'm GJ504B. What can I say? I love pink! It's the color that looks best on me. I'm an extremely hot gas giant planet, 4 times more massive than Jupiter. My incredibly intense heat causes me to glow pink, or magenta, if you prefer.
I'm under so much pressure and high temperatures. I'm 55 Cancri-E. Beneath my molten lava surface could be a precious diamond because I have such high density. I also have lots of silicates in my atmosphere reflecting light, making my sky sparkly. And through my sparkly sky, you would see my sibling planet, Galileo, watching over me.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
They call me Osiris, HD209458B. I'm an evaporating gas giant. Soon just a core is all that will be left of me. My atmosphere has hydrogen, carbon, and oxygen that are all evaporating away. Orbiting close to a yellow star like your sun, my hydrogen tail creates quite a display.
Beautiful azure blue, HD189733B. But don't let my appearance fool you. There's nothing calm about me. My atmosphere is filled with particles of glass. My wind speeds are extremely fast, blowing faster than the speed of sound. I have storms of sideways raining glass swirling all around.
Kepler 1625b, a gas giant that is very special, you see. Because I may have an exomoon orbiting around me. We could be a binary planet, too. But our size ratio is much like Earth and your moon. My companion's exomoon status is still waiting to be confirmed. We hope it will be soon.
Out beyond the 8 planets that you already know. There are many more solar systems to explore, and we should go. Different stars that have their own planets and their own solar systems. Would you like to go with me and see if we can meet some?
I'm Exoplanet HD100546b, a super Jupiter gas giant planet that is one of the largest exoplanets you'll meet. I orbit a star with a circumstellar disk made up of gases, dust, and debris. The material in these disks is what forms gas giant planets, just like me.
They call me the Whiplash Planet, HR5183b. A super Jupiter three times the size of him. I have an eccentric 74-year egg-shaped orb, you see. I slingshot around my star, speeding up as I get closer and slowing down as I retreat. I'm a bit of a wrecking ball because I wreak havoc on any regular orbiting planets I meet.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
We may look like Earth and the Sun, but look closer and you will see. With my yellow main sequence star, Kepler 452, I'm Kepler 452b. I'm in the habitable zone of my star and could have liquid water on me. Which means, because I'm so similar to Earth, that there could be life on me.
OGLE2005BLG390LB. My nickname is Hoth, like the ice world in Star Wars. I'm icy and rocky. I'm so cold that even my atmospheric gases freeze, adding to my snowy surface. I'm too cold for life to survive on me, so I orbit my cool red dwarf star quietly in the constellation Scorpius.
1.8 days to orbit my star, a hot Jupiter gas giant, that's me. One side always day, one side always night. I'm a tidally locked planet named Wasp 76b. My hot temperatures on my day side are so extreme that they vaporize iron in my atmosphere. But when the vapor reaches my night side, it cools and rains fiery iron down on this sphere.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
I defy the laws of physics with my burning ice! I'm Gliese 436b. I have a scorching hot surface because I'm 15 times closer to my sun than Mercury. Oddly, my surface is mostly ice, but it's on fire! How could that be? My gravity is so strong that it compresses any water vapor back into ice on me.
I'm hot, 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 7,800 degrees, an ultra-hot Jupiter KELT-9b. I'm so close to my star that my surface sizzles and can be even hotter than some stars can be. I'm in a tightly locked 36-hour polar orbit around my star, which looks like I'm orbiting vertically. And my fast spinning star is boiling away my atmosphere by blasting me with heat and radiation constantly.
Let's go meet an exoplanet. They orbit other stars. Some are very similar, some very different from ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination.
Let's go find some exoplanets and see if we can meet them.
Similar to Earth in age and size, I'm Gliese 1132b. So close to my star that it ripped and stole my atmosphere away from me. During my 1.6-day orbit, my star pulls and stretches me and causes violent volcanic activity. But I'm clever, and I'm using the gases from the volcanoes to build a brand new atmosphere around me.
One of the largest known exoplanets, a super Jupiter, I'm G2UBB. I'm young and have a circumplanetary disk all around me. Also known as a moon-forming disk, this is exciting to see. Because this is where the birth of new moons happens. They'll form and then orbit me.
The TOI-178 system, we move in almost perfect harmony. The outer five of our six planets exist in a resonance of 18 to 9 to 6 to 4 to 3. This means we orbit our orange star and line up with each other very regularly.
For every 18 orbits
I have 9.
I have 6. I have 4. I have 3.
Now you've met some exoplanets. They orbit other stars in their very own solar systems far outside of ours. Strange and mystical worlds with wonders beyond imagination. Keep looking at the stars and maybe you'll discover one.